spread the information as much as possible. What do you think can be done to help the raise the awareness, or will Mother Earth, as it were, find a way to make people, you know, look up from from their day-to-day lives because of Gaia Rage, basically more activity in the weather, more extreme weather? Do you think that will help to make people finally, you know, wake up to all of this?
Well, there's two major shocks in that realm as far as sort of forcing people to become aware and to simplify and naturalize and localize their home life, and that is the extreme weather cycles, the crashes, the cold, the hot, the freezing, the droughts, and pestilence. I mean, it sounds very biblical. And then the other is your self-awareness about nature and your love of nature. See, we need to go into nature to learn about nature and to learn about our bodies. If we've been living indoors too much and we're losing our instincts, then we go into nature to learn about what being simple is and being local is. So I used to take hot and cold showers every day. I took thousands of them, and I've had thousands of massages and thousands of hot baths and lived outdoors for 15 years. And I still bicycle around and take steam baths and hot and cold.
Yeah.
There's ways of getting your body really tuned up, but it's like body enlightenment. It's like becoming energy flow. And anciently, it was called Qi Kung. Qi Kung is the ancient science of body energy flow.
Mm.
It's exercise, massage, acupuncture, herbs, and all that. So China is actually a great source of that, but they're industrializing really fast right now. So
yeah,
probably more Qi. Well, I don't know how much Qi Kung there is in China. They claim there's 300 million people doing Qi Kung, but I think that includes Tai Chi.
Mm-hmm.
All these things are, and yoga, are very good for your body to become healthy. And is how much do you want to be healthy?
Yeah.
Or do you want money? I mean, it depends on what do you want with your life and yourself and your values. What are your values?
That's right. I totally agree. In the only aspect to all of this is, of course, that this is now happening globally, and as more countries develop industrially and all of this, it seems like the planet is taking the root of the majority, and in the end, it feels like even if you try to improve yourself, there's nowhere to run. I don't mean to say that you shouldn't do anything at all. I'm not saying that.
Well,
but
nowhere to run is kind of an escapist idea, and what I'm seeing is more as a positive thing. Are you living where you can be healthy?
Mm.
And if health is not a high priority, if your car and your job are more your bills are more important, then that's your choice.
Yeah.
And it's all about choosing what is the most critical needs that you have.
Yeah.
And your awareness expanding. So in a way, it's a self-sorting thing.
Yeah.
The more the economy crashes, the more people get sick, and the more depressed they get, or angry, or they become more natural. So the higher the price of oil is, the more people are going to save money. Well, are they going to realize what efficiency is?
Yeah.
See, it's efficiency is a huge concept of looking at technology. And then if we look at nature, what is the big concept there? It's balancing.
Yeah. I believe in that too, definitely. As you say, the balance of things, obviously. And I think that this will be a great place to kind of round things off. And I think it has been, very informative, and it's very nice to have you on. And we'll definitely want to have you, back on at some time if you're willing to do that with us.
Oh, sure, I'd love to. Gaia Cycles is expanding. Finishing my book now, and it could be two books. It's so big. It keeps expanding.
Okay. Well, how will that will be available later, through website or through like Amazon.com or something like that? How does that work?
Through my website. I do have the Gaia Rage, which I send out to people for free.
Okay.
And then I have a 108-page book, which right now is $10 through the mail.
Mm-hmm.
So those are the two sources right now. But I have my other organic health magazine called Primal Instincts.
Mm-hmm.
And that's $5 through the mail, or I also do trades too.
Mm-hmm.
So I do take cash. You can send cash to bills through the mail. And I was going to ask you maybe another time, like you could talk to me about the weather in Sweden and the north coast of Sweden. is the seas rising there?
Yeah, definitely. I know idea if the seas are rising. The north of Sweden, because it connects, you know, with Norway on the west side of Sweden, of course. But if you go to the east side on the what is known as Östersjön, I don't think that that is rising at the moment. I have to actually look in at that, but I don't think so. It's tremendously polluted, I know, but and they're fishing it. You know, they're you know, all the fish is gone, you know, basically, and they're putting in legislations to stop that and so forth. But no, I don't think it's rising, no.
Okay, well, I just am curious about the entire Arctic and how the weather's working there.
Okay, yeah.
I need to go and have some kefir that we've been making from goat milk here for my breakfast.
Okay, yeah, definitely. You know, give us out your website again, if you can, before we leave you, so people know where they can find your books and so forth.
Yeah, it's EFN dot, well, okay, there's EFN.org, or if you just go Ecosma, E-C-O-Z-M-A, Ecosma, Sunergy. So it's Ecosma / Sunergy. And those are, I'm the only Ecosma on the web. So if you Google that, you'll get it. Or if you go, if you want to know the exact address, you've got a link on your website.
That's right.
And also, it's www.efn.org/Ecosma/Ecosma. So EFN and Ecosma, if you just use those words, you'll get there because it's the only Ecosma on the web.
All right,
and
definitely.
And the other site, I've got two sites there. It's called Ecosma, and the other Sunergy, S-U-N-E-R-G-Y.
Okay, yeah, check that out. And again, these links will be on the information page on our website, so people can find those easily. And again, thank you so much, Michael, for coming on. This has been a pleasure, and looking forward to speaking with you sometime again.
Yes, let's do it.
Thank you so much.
Aloha.
Red Ice Creations Radio will be back again on Sunday with another program lined up for you. Remember that you can participate in this radio show. You can find all the details about this in our radio section on our website, redicecreations.com. We also have two different forums on our site that you should check out. And if you feel up for it, join in on the discussion. We have our own Red Ice Creations forum. We also have the MTSAR forum. Just type in redicecreations.com/MTSAR forum, MTSAR forum, if you want to access that. You'll find all the links to all of this on the left-hand side on our website. There you'll find links on how you can subscribe, how to search our news archive, access our shop, and much, much more. It's all up there for you to enjoy. All right, thanks for tuning in, and thanks to producer Fredrik Palmgren. We will talk more on Sunday again. Until then, all the best. This is Henrik Palmgren. Do take care.
If it's running out of thread, could you do this for me, my friend?